watching KOB Eyewitness News with Danielle, Colton, and Steve.
If you find yourself glued to a chair all day, we'll show you what you can do to make sure that you don't hurt your back.
Welcome back. If you sit all day at work or school, then you could be in for some back pain. So Dr. James Hirning with the Joint Chiropractic of Albuquerque here to explain what he calls sitting disease. What is this?
Sitting disease is the term that we use for the changes that take place in the lower back as a result of a prolonged sitting, like sitting in front of the computer desk at work.
Like how many hours would you say?
Hours, many hours, okay. Hours after hour hours after hour. Hours. A lot of people have jobs where they're working 40 hours a week. They're in front of the computer, sitting at their desk most of the day. They take very few breaks, or you get college students that study for long periods of time. It's we're starting to see a lot of detrimental effects that are starting to take place in these people's low backs.
So we brought a desk chair out here. One of the nicer ones that a lot of us don't really get to sit in. But if you can show me a proper way to sit.
Yes. Scoot back in the chair a little bit so you have some support in the lower back.
Oh, okay.
And then the height of the chair should be so that your feet are flat on the floor.
Oh, okay.
So you're not dangling your feet.
Okay.
So, and then your knees should be at a 90-degree angle when your feet are flat on the floor.
Okay.
Then that'll give you support. And then if you're at a workstation where you have a computer, the desktop should be set so your hands sit on the table and they're level, and the elbows are bent at a 90-degree angle. That way you're not slouching forward or leaning back this way. This is the kind of slouching posture is what's starting to really have an effect on patients' necks and lower back.
So here, what do we see happen with the spine?
So what we're looking at here is a model of the spine, and the way our spines are designed. We have the vertebrae, and then we have a disc in between each one of these bones in the spine. Now, this disc is a shock absorber, and when our spine is properly aligned and we're sitting with good posture, these discs function to work as that shock absorber and decrease the amount of pain and pressure on the spine.
Okay.
Now, if you're slouching, what happens, and I'm going to use this as a visual aid.
Do I need to put a tarp on? There's a jelly donut on
it. I promise I won't splash you, okay? So what this block represents is one of the hard bones of the spine, the vertebrae.
Yeah.
And this jelly donut right here represents one of the discs, because the disc is real soft and squishy like that, and its function is to be a shock absorber like that. Okay?
Okay.
All right, can you see that all right? And then when we sit and you slouch for a long period of time, instead of the spine being aligned this way, it's out of alignment this way.
Okay.
Well, long term, you sit like that for hour after hour after hour, it starts changing the shape of that disc.
Okay.
And the bones, and if it continues long enough, the extra pressure on there, you can see what happens to the disc.
Yeah,
that is what we call a disc herniation. That is an extremely painful and permanent condition.
Wow.
And this is what we're trying to avoid.
Okay, sit up,
sit up
on the floor.
Yes.
90 degrees, feet,
correct.
Hands. Perfect. Thank
correct.
You so much, Dr. James
My
Hirning.
Pleasure.
The Joint Albuquerque Chiropractic. We'll be right back.